I see tables. I see France. I see Notion's competitors. Chance. That was one of the worst attempts at a joke. This video is about a Notion competitor, Fibery. Every other week, a video I make is like, is this a Notion competitor? Because people want to know. And also, like, I got to keep Notion in check. Don't care if I consult about your stuff. What if one day you die? I don't know. Hopefully not. Multi-billion-dollar company, by the way. Fibery is a Notion alternative. Sort of Airtable, Google Docs, Trello, all that kind of stuff. It's a very interesting application that I stumbled upon recently that makes some different customizable views that Notion sort of has. I mean, it's got a lot of these like table, board, list, timeline, calendar, but whiteboards aren't a thing. So Notion, you don't got that, make that, all right? Because ClickUp's got whiteboards, you know, you gotta compete with ClickUp. And they also have some automations, which are really cool, and some decent integration. If it's got Zapier and IntegraMAT, you can do a lot of things, so it's good enough for me. If we showcase the pricing model here, solo, free forever, $0. And it's also 100% free for startups with annual recurring revenue less than theirs for 1 year. And Ukrainian companies until 2023, which I think is pretty cool. 50% discount for nonprofit organizations and $10 a month in general for the standard plan, which gives you read-only users of unlimited. The pro version, which gives you SAML, single access, multi-login, some login thing, unlimited version history. So interesting pricing model, definitely high priced in my opinion. When you switch to pay monthly, it gets even worse. But let's see what it actually has to offer. The general premise of the application, according to the company, is pretty funny. It's like Fibery versus Airtable, Notion, Coda, ClickUp, Monday, Trello, Jira. This is one of the better things I've seen on our website. I love marketing that makes things real, and this is hilarious. So this shows Fibery. This is like the biased comparison. And this is Fibery versus Airtable. And I like how it shows like applicability areas, work management, database backend, and knowledge management. And how it's got this section covered, but it doesn't really have database backend covered. Whereas Airtable, that's more its expertise. And with Fibery versus Notion, it's more about work management than knowledge management. I think that's totally fair. Notion is more of a knowledge management than work management platform, and is definitely more for individuals and teams, but like Fibery's catered more towards teams. I like the fact that they articulate this so easily and says what Notion is better for. For personal life stuff, Notion. Small, medium company wiki. For processes and work management for medium and large teams, this is what they're trying to go after. They're not trying to go after everybody, which I respect. So I'm gonna go into this example workspace that they gave me when I said I wanted to get started with a digital agency. I like that it's got a whiteboard. It's like, all right, we got project management. We got to deal with hourly rates, time logging, companies and contacts. This is something where I can actually see myself working in this and dealing with it for different things. Now, I can just use Miro and connect it to Notion in various ways, but I appreciate the fact that this is an application. Makes sense to have that and project management connected. So if we go to the example CRM here, we'll see that it has a different feel. So like, if I click on this, I'm just going to change the name. But if I have to go here to change the whole thing. Notion's got a different functionality where the open button would be here. There is a easy way to write a description here by clicking on it and typing in there. Not sure I feel the back that you have to like get in there to do it. This is their sort of relation property. So this is connecting to their company contacts. This is connecting to projects. This is a tag where I can do a multi-tag selection. I can enter multiple rows here really quickly by doing something like this. Example, dog company. If I press shift enter, I can go into the next row really quickly. Also, it was kind of a cute thing they just did there, where if I press this guy, just showing you, you can delete like that. You can delete the whole table. So this is sort of like a visualization situation going on. And this is the whole CRM. So it's got a lot of high level stuff here. Or like if I open this page, you'll see the different things it's connected to, i.e. different projects in the CRM. And then these are like the different databases that connect the whole thing. So I like the cascading sort of database situation here. And then if we look at the project management, see all the projects. Right here is where I would delete the table. Right here, if I open this guy, you could delete the page here, duplicate it, shows you shortcuts for how to close panels and stuff. It's got the basic description as a property here. If I open this one as well, you can see that it has tasks associated to the project, rates. So it's a little bit more of a robust feel than Notion. I definitely do appreciate it for what it is and how it seems to be a little bit more close to like ClickUp and Trello and Airtable than Notion from an overall clicking around perspective, but the aesthetic definitely I could see where it could be confused with Notion in some senses. What I like to do is check the property type. So if I press plus here, you can see there's the different fields. You can hide them just like you could with Notion. There are different things here. So I could edit a formula. decently robust formula system. Very similar, it looks like, to what Notion has. Like, let's test this one. So let's make a new formula. So new field relation. You can see that there's text, rich text, which is like the inside of a page sort of view. A number, single select, multi-select, date, checkbox. Pretty simple stuff. So let's do a lookup as a rollup, I'm sure. If I do formula, teens manager, customer manager equals true. Okay, let's do this. What about an empty formula? Is empty customer manager. Okay, that works as a formula. And then you can do equals false to like reverse that. So I reversed it. Let's edit the formula. Let me do equals true and see if it was empty, it would be checked off. But since they're not, so I could take this guy, make another tab here really quick. You could see there's no manager. So that works there. Formulas in here, pretty interesting. There is a litany of templates to choose from on the bottom left. You can sync your Airtable tables really quickly. Let's see if they have anything that's like Notion. Nope, that's fine. And if you want to do Control K, you'll be able to search across the platform. But I'm going to search for is the rules. So to create rules, choose a database. So if I go to database, okay, let's pick a database here. Project management for all projects. So you can make a rule here. And really quickly, as like a move to situation, you can click on any of these and it's got the action. So you can like convert it as in move it somewhere, or we can delete it. So I can move this to like tasks. So example task, then move it to task. Then it went to example task. Okay, so if we go to this database editor, you'll see here that we have the option to integrate with different things like Airtable, even Notion evidently. Would be okay, so you can do integrations here, or you can add automations and relations. So here's an example rule. So let's go to the project management one. Let's add a rule here. Starts when project is created, then create. Let's do tasks, so you can select tasks, then maybe create a create logo. So let's do something like a new creative project. You do another one, do tasks, and then prepare a brand mark. Let's try this guy. So when a new project is created, you'll see exactly what happens. So new project. Okay, now let's add this here to show the tasks. You'll see when I added this guy here, I added the subtask of prepare a brand mark. You can see it showed one action was executed and one was failed. So failed to execute action create loop is detected. Okay, so I guess I needed to make multiple steps to that. But that's cool. And you also create buttons, which is very similar to what Coda has. So basically when you click something, maybe it can set up a recurring task. This definitely gives me better project management vibes than Notion. I think as a Notion consultant, I often find issues when it comes to actually automating some things. And when I see it having real integrations, when it has real automations, buttons, and even having things like just general database structures that make sense, this makes me feel better. Now, I do not like that there are very easy ways to delete databases. I think always having a user experience more in a page layout is my preference. So I can appreciate for this for what it is while acknowledging its differences from Notion. If you want to see more tips on how to improve your productivity, check out this video right here.